De Junkers Ju-87 Stuka, or Sturzkampfflugzeug, literally dive bomber, was a German bomber and ground attack aircraft. In this video, I'm going to introduce you how it was actually used. The dive attack was one of the most accurate ways of bombing. It was used because crews were expected to be able to get 50% of their bombs within 25 meters of the center of the target. The comparable distance for high-flying level bombers was 2 or 3 times larger. Although the dive bombing attack was not accurate enough to be worthwhile against small, hard targets such as individual tanks, it was very effective against soft targets such as motor vehicles, which were vulnerable to near misses. Against a fortification, a Staffel or squadron of Ju-87s stood a good chance of scoring several direct hits with large bombs like the SC-500. Against artillery positions, a load would be one SC-250 under the fuselage and 4 small SC-50 under the wings. When approaching their target, the Ju-87s would typically fly in a 3 aircraft formation, the so-called Kette in German, at about 15,000 feet, cruising at 240 km per hour. Larger formations would be made up of several of these Ketten in line astern, with a spacing of about 300 meters between aircraft, up to a usual maximum of about 30 machines. Prior to entering his dive, the pilot switched on his reflector sight, trimmed the aircraft for the dive, set the pull-out altitude on the contact altimeter, closed the radiator flaps, throttled back the engine, and open the ventilation air supply to the windscreen. Finally, he switched on the wind-driven screamer if required and opened the dive brakes to counter the severe nose-up trim change which would otherwise result. The signal to attack was given by the formation leader starting his dive. For strikes on smaller targets, the aircraft would move into echelon during the approach and peel off and attack in line astern. Against larger targets such as harbors, the dive bombers would bend over and attack by Ketten. The pilot was able to see directly beneath his aircraft through a small window set in the floor, and so was able to judge when to begin his bend. Once it was established in its dive, typically at an angle of 80 degrees, the Ju-87 with extended dive brakes gained speed only gradually. A dive from 15,000 feet to a release altitude of 3,000 feet took about 30 seconds, during which the pilot controlled his aircraft to hold the target in the center of his reflector sight. After the pull-out, the pilot regained control and retracted his dive brakes, opened the throttle, trimmed for level flight, and made his gateway.